Hi, welcome to Free Tech Training. Today we are going to see how to impress the interviewer in the very first 10 minutes of your interview. Let's get started. So, when the interviewer asks you any question, please always answer with examples. This is the number one tip, because do not give like one-line answers. If you give one-line answers, you're giving them a chance to ask you more questions. And this makes them feel that you don't have enough knowledge about that topic. So you always need to prepare questions with examples. Before even they ask you any examples, you have to come up with examples. If they ask you like, tell me about business analysis techniques, okay? Instead of saying brainstorming, focus groups and all that, you need to come up with an example. Like during a brainstorming session, this is what will happen. During a focus group session, let me give an example how a focus group will happen. Like that, you need to always present with examples. Okay, do not give one-line answers. That's not the right way of answering. Next is you need to listen to the question very well, okay, and answer appropriately. So when the interviewer begins to talk, do not like interpret before even he like tells you what he wants. Okay, some people will be like before even the interviewer finish the question, right, they will start answering. Do not do that. You need to be quiet and then let him complete the question completely, and then you need to like understand exactly what he wants, and then you have to like respond appropriately. Because some most interviews are what I have seen is the interviewer will ask a question and then immediately the interviewer will be like the candidate will start answering, and then the interviewer will be again like repeatedly asking the same question, like he'll be like, do you understand what I'm asking? So don't give like a chance like that. This makes interviewer feel like you don't have enough understanding about the topic, or you don't understand the question correctly. So you need to listen to the question very well and then take a moment, and then you need to make sure that you are answering appropriately. Okay, that's the right way of answering. Be patient, be quiet, and then listen very well. That's an important soft skill that you have to learn. So next one is be responsive. So for example, they're asking you, your last work experience is like unrelated to whatever job opening currently we have. So you are completely from non-IT background and you're applying for an IT job. So like, tell me, why do you want to apply for this job? So for questions like this, you need to be like very responsive. Okay, you need to say that, of course, that's what I know, that I don't have an experience in IT, but I'm willing to learn. Also, I have like, made sure that for the last 3 months or 4 months, I'm continuously learning the topics. Okay, so you need to like tell the interviewer that how willing you are there to like come into IT industry, and for that, what measures you have taken for the last 4 months or 5 months, how much you have invested your time and all the certifications you have done and all the like topics you have learned and how much training you have went through for to get into IT. Like, you need to tell him like how much interest and passion you have to enter into this new industry, instead of telling him that I don't have experience and I'm going to learn from now. That's not the way you tell. You have to say that I understand that I don't have an IT experience, but now I'm willing to get into IT. For that, I have done my side of research and I have done my side of training and then my side of certification, and I'm now well prepared, okay, to get into this industry. And you need to be responsive, and you need to like also tell like how much effort and time you have invested for getting this new job. Okay, if something, always make sure that if they ask you any question that for that you don't have any experience, right, you should always say that how much interested and passionate you are to get that new job, and how much you have done research and how much you have worked towards that new goal, okay, that you want to achieve. That's how you need to answer. Next is you need to be clear about the concepts, okay, very clear about the concepts, okay. If they're asking about what is Jira, what is Confluence, be very, very clear about those concepts, okay, because if you are not clear with the concepts, the interviewer will definitely not hire you, okay? Whatever you know, you should be very thorough and very clear, okay? So make sure whatever in the job description they have added, the skills, whatever they want, you need to be very thorough with the concepts. If you are not thorough, please learn every day and make sure you know the concepts very well. And honesty is very important, okay? So don't try to fake things, okay? You say that I'm an expert in SQL. Now he's going to ask you SQL, like with examples, and he's going to throw you all like scenario based questions, okay? You need to be honest about your strength and weaknesses, and like you have to like tell him that I'm a beginner in SQL, okay? And I'm trying to learn, and I know this and this, and I'm like willing to learn, I'll definitely improve. So you need to like tell your strength and how much strength you have and how much weakness you have as well, because if you're trying to fake a lot of skills in your resume, right, they are going to like question your integrity, okay? Now they'll be like, okay, this person fakes too much in the resume and I don't want such kind of candidates. Instead, you can always say that I know I'm a beginner and I have learned this much and I'm trying to improve my SQL skills, or I'm trying to improve my technical skills, or trying to improve my reporting skills. Like, you need to always tell your strengths, and also to some extent you can tell your weaknesses as well and how you are trying to improve those skills. Do not fake a lot of experience in your resume. You are never going to get a job. And the next one is being polite. Okay, you need to be polite and you need to be calm and composed in the interview. Do not be rude. Okay, that rude attitude or something like will give you a bad opinion. The very first impression is very important. So you need to be polite. Okay? That's the difference being polite and being shy. So what I'm trying to say is you need to be confident. Okay, that is that. But you should not be rude too. Okay, you should always be polite, and you need to be calm and composed, and also be very confident. And if they ask you like, okay, do you have any questions for us? Okay, most candidates will be like, no, I don't have any questions. But you need to definitely ask about the questions. Okay, for example, what is this job? Okay, what is the role you're looking for? Are you looking for a beginner? Are you looking for like a mid-level candidate? Are you looking for an expert? What are the skills that you are expecting? Okay, can you tell me how can I improve my way of answering? And these are the questions you definitely need to ask the interviewer, okay? Let's say that you're not getting a job on the very first interview. But these feedback from the interviewer will definitely, like, you next time, right, you will definitely improve, okay? You have to get those feedbacks and work on those feedbacks and make sure in the next interview, right, you're improving your interviewing skills. It's definitely, you need to, at the end of the interview, you need to ask the interviewer about what is the job description that they're looking for and how you need to improve your skills and what is exactly the skills that they are looking for in the company. And yeah, you need to definitely ask those questions and make sure you improve that, okay? And getting feedback is very important, and they will give you honest feedback, because most of the interviewers will be like, okay, at least you have some interest, and you are like having interest to making sure to improve, right? That's a good way of like telling that you are so much interested and passionate about this job, okay? So you need to keep asking questions. I hope this interview is helpful. So please work on those tips and start preparing for your interview. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.